This is the audio version of the Time of Life magazine. The Hate Edition 5. Page 5. The heading of this magazine reads, The Curse Less Curse. Here is a story for you. It is titled, Balaam's Message. Balaam said, Build me 7 altars here, and prepare 7 bulls and 7 rams for me. Balak did as Balaam said, and the two of them offered a bull and a ram on each altar. Then Balaam said to Balak, Stay here beside your offering while I go aside. Perhaps the Lord will come to meet with me. Whatever he reveals to me I will tell you. Then he went off to a barren height. God met with him, and Balaam said, I have prepared 7 altars, and on each altar, I have offered a bull and a ram. The Lord put a word in Balaam's mouth and said, Go back to Balak and give him this word. So he went back to him and found him standing beside his offering, with all the Moabite officials. Then Balaam spoke his message. Balak brought me from Aram, the king of Moab from the eastern mountains. Come, he said, curse Jacob for me, come, denounce Israel. How can I curse those whom God has not cursed? How can I denounce those whom the Lord has not denounced? From the rocky peaks I see them, from the heights I view them. I see a people who live apart and do not consider themselves one of the nations. Who can count the dust of Jacob or number even a fourth of Israel? Let me die the death of the righteous, and may my final end be like theirs. Balak said to Balaam, What have you done to me? I brought you to curse my enemies, but you have done nothing but bless them. He answered, Must I not speak what the Lord puts in my mouth? Arise, Balak, and listen. Hear me, son of Zippor. God is not human, that he should lie, not a human being, that he should change his mind. Does he speak and then not act? Does he promise and not fulfill? I have received a command to bless, he has blessed, and I cannot change it. No misfortune is seen in Jacob, no misery observed in Israel. The Lord their God is with them, the shout of the king is among them. God brought them out of Egypt. They have the strength of a wild ox. There is no divination against Jacob, no evil omens against Israel. It will now be said of Jacob and of Israel, See what God has done. The people rise like a lioness, they rouse themselves like a lion that does not rest till it devours its prey and drinks the blood of its victims. Then Balak said to Balaam, Neither curse them at all nor bless them at all. Balaam answered, Did I not tell you I must do whatever the Lord says? Numbers 22 and 23. Now, this man Balaam was a wizard. Balak handed the children of Israel to this man for destruction. When the case of the Israelites came to him instead of consulting demonic powers, he went to consult the God of the Israelites to hear what he would say, for he knew they were God's people. What he says would determine what he would do. That night God came to him and said to him, Do not go with them. You must not put a curse on those people, because they are blessed. Numbers 22 verse 12. But Balak through Balaam tried to bribe God 3 different times by offering bulls and rams. But his offerings could not change God's mind. In fact, he told Balak and Balaam that he is not a man who changes his mind. That he is the faithful God. But why? Why didn't Balaam use divination to curse them? He would have ignored God and done it anyway. Well, he didn't do that because God told him that no curse can touch Jacob. No magic has any power against Israel. And secondly, apart from the other things he told him that blessed is everyone who blesses Israel, and cursed is everyone who curses him. And so, a law was passed in the realms of the Spirit, and it states that anyone who is redeemed by the Lord cannot be cursed, like we see in the above case. Balaam and Balak are not the redeemed of the Lord, and so, they could not curse God's people in the name of the Lord or by divination. Okay, you might say, but can an Israelite curse a fellow Israelite in the name of the Lord? The answer is in the book of Leviticus 19 verse 17 to 18. It says, Do not hate a fellow Israelite in your heart. Rebuke your neighbor frankly so you will not share in their guilt. Do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against anyone among your people, but love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. What of a Christian? Can a Christian curse his fellow Christian in the name of Jesus? Here is the answer. The Lord Jesus said, "A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." John 13 verse 34-35. Okay, what if a Christian goes ahead to curse his fellow Christian in the name of Jesus even though he knows that he shouldn't curse, let alone curse in the name of the Lord? What will happen to him? Well, by God's standard, whoever hates his brother is a murderer. You have to hate your brother to be able to curse him. Anyone who hates a brother or sister is a murderer, and you know that no murderer has eternal life residing in him. 1 John 3:15. Well, can a Christian curse a non-Christian in the name of Jesus? The answer is, but to you who are listening I say, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who mistreat you. If someone slaps you on one cheek, turn to them the other also. If someone takes your coat, do not withhold your shirt from them. Give to everyone who asks you, and if anyone takes what belongs to you, do not demand it back. Luke 6:27-30. It is a great offense to curse a fellow Christian or a non-Christian using the name of the Lord Jesus, because the name of the Lord is a strong tower, the righteous runs to it and is safe and set on high far above evil. Proverbs 18 verse 10. The Amplified Bible Version. However, we know that there are non-believers who have called on the name of the Lord and they had deliverance, because salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved. Acts 4:12. How have we turned the name, whose duty is to save, into a magic wand, a tool useful for cursing? Is this not a sin? Is this not an abuse of power? Indeed, power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. Here is another short story for your perusal. It is titled, The Samaritan Opposition. As the time approached for him to be taken up to heaven, Jesus resolutely set out for Jerusalem. And he sent messengers on ahead, who went into a Samaritan village to get things ready for him, but the people there did not welcome him, because he was heading for Jerusalem. When the disciples James and John saw this, they asked, "Lord, do you want us to call fire down from heaven to destroy them?" But Jesus turned and rebuked them. Then he and his disciples went to another village. Luke 9 verse 51-56. No wonder that when we curse people in the name of Jesus today, the next day, we see them in a new car. We mean to say that they keep prospering. Why is it so? The answer is that the name speaks mercy for them and for us. "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing," pleads the name of Jesus on everyone's behalf. Now, do you know how many people have cursed you in the name of Jesus and it is not coming near your tent? And do we know how many people we have cursed in the name of Jesus and it is not coming near them? It is because the name saves and it does not condemn. That is why we all are not consumed. Blessed be the holy name of Jesus Christ. Dear body of Christ, we at the studio are beating our chest and crying, "O Lord, have mercy upon us. We are not worthy to call on your name. We have gone out of the way and thought we were on track. O Lord, have mercy. Save us, for we cannot save ourselves. Save us from all our hidden sins. Lord, have mercy." We got this information from the book of Galatians 5 verse 13-15. It says, "You, my brothers and sisters, were called to be free. But do not use your freedom to indulge the flesh, rather, serve one another humbly in love. For the entire law is fulfilled in keeping this one command, love your neighbor as yourself. If you bite and devour each other, watch out, or you will be destroyed by each other. If you have been blessed by this truth, share it. For the bride must prepare herself spotless for her king. Please do all you can to go to heaven. God gives the ticket to heaven through his Son, and it has been fully paid for. This and more are God's free gifts to everyone who believes in the Son. Anyone who has the Son, has life. If you need the Lord Jesus, call him and he would answer you. So mightily grew the word of God through you and it prevailed. This message is powered by the Holy Spirit and brought to you by God in conjunction with Stamp Eternity on my Eyeball Studio. End of article.